I just got switched up so quick. Y'all don't even know. I thought we was gonna have a banjo. I was like, no,
yeah,
not
you
the
thought
banjo.
You were about to look sexy on cam for a bit. That's crazy. I mean, you do that all the time. So listen.
Me? Anyways, yes.
We are familiar with John numbers, sure.
Uh-huh.
5 years of me getting planked at the ledge.
Uh-huh. Okay, for sure.
However, on the other hand, Grunt Charles, I've actually never heard of him until just now. I think I might have seen him at an encore or two on stream. But, you know, he isn't the same crew as me. Shout out to Grunt Gang. And I don't think John gets to play too many snakes, not since Brawl. Well, I take that back. Actually, he plays HO3K Looney. Shout out to Looney the Dune.
Period.
So he will know what to do in this matchup, but... let's just say Snake is one of those characters, right, where every Snake main plays so vastly different. It's kind of like PT, where like they're not all playing the same game because Snake has all those options. And the first thing we'll see, which is really funny, the ledge trapping. Shout out to Up Smash.
I don't even know if it's ledge trapping at this point. Y'all already know
I think it might just be like, you know, some kind of
mind game.
Enigma. Mini game.
Literally, like... What's going through? I could tell y'all what's going through Charles' head right now.
He just blew himself up. So.
It's literally like that. Oh my god! You know, I have like the mind of a master or the master of the mind. Like you'll already know, I'm like so creative.
It's either like what's going through his mind right now is either like the zoom in Jimmy Neutron thing, or just like radio static white noise.
And for sure, but
and whatever gets him to win, man, I'm all for this. Snake is a character where he gets a lot off doing a little, but also gets a lot off doing the crazy stuff. Haven't really seen Charles bust out the crazy stuff too much yet, but again, never seen it before, so I'm actually really interested to see how this goes.
Do
you see that?
Oh, excuse me? Oh, hold on. Oh, you better hold up just a little bit. Did that back air just collide with whatever that was?
Was that what the Wii Fit back air was?
Wii Fit lived! I'm still just literally... John, I don't even know how John did it. Oh, God.
Wii Fit will take a deep breath and take less damage, hence giving her less knockback.
Quite
didn't
corny.
Even take up.
Oh god. Oh my god.
Only that would happen to John numbers, like I'm not even kidding. Alright, so
too much.
Grenade gonna betray John there, or rather, you know, help Snake. And I mean, yeah, John sitting comfortably here with Charles at 79 and counting.
I mean, for sure. I want to kind of point out how, you know, John has been at a very comfortable percent almost this entire game. That first stock, he was only at 60% that entire time, while Charles was at like 180%.
Here we go.
But for sure, like, John has been just keeping it so, like, even and just playing the zoning game. Like,
of course, because that's what John's best at, right?
Absolutely, for sure. But I just love how well he's doing it, particularly because this is Snake. And, you know... Snake normally does outzone people.
Yeah, Snake is like the zoner,
absolutely,
right?
For
but
sure.
To see John like take advantage of, you know, use his grenades against him, right? Play the game himself. I mean, like, it just goes to show you how well he is, you know, formed up the matchup.
Awesome,
pretty awesome.
For sure, gotta be very careful with those C4s and that absolute that kick to kick and then the kick in the face and then that's just what it's gonna be.
Kick
and
in
then
the face, baby.
We're already back from opposite sides of the ledge. Gotta be very careful with that up air. Oh no.
Okay, here we go. Yeah, John, it's crazy because you have to think about this too, right? Where John will kind of throw Snake off stage and get the deep breath. Not only does he go Super Saiyan, but he gets some health back.
For sure, like you literally do, you heal 2%, and at one point in Smash 4, it actually used to be 1% that she healed from everything.
And then they buffed her. I don't know. They just did it.
They made this.
They were like,
yes.
At Nintendo headquarters, they were like, I want to see John numbers one more. Let's buff Wii Fit. They did that. So
I mean,
shout out to Nintendo.
The only other Wii Fit that you'll be seeing is Varun Wii Fit, and I'm not entirely sure who else, but. I mean, for sure, we definitely do
love Wii Fit.
Love the double
don't
parries.
Don't know if that was on purpose, but I'll act like it was.
Oh, period. Yes, for sure. But
good dash, or rather, I guess, good grenade to stuff out the dash attack. Not going to find a combo off it. That's something Snakes will do a lot, too, where they grab the grenade and they shield it so they can drop it. And then if the opponent hits a grenade, they get a cool combo off it.
Did you see that? Did you see that wave bounce? Did you see that?
I don't think I did. What happened?
John wave bounced and then went for a downer. And then almost going to get the life right out of him.
And you see how John just retreats to the ledge? Like they love the ledge more than any other Smasher I know.
I mean, the ledge is your best friend at this point.
When you need to fall asleep at night or when you need to cry, the ledge is there for you. And the reverse F-tilt up in the sky.
Let me tell
Game
you,
one.
Is the ledge going to do that for you?
Ledge does not have enough tilt. No, sir. No, ma'am.
I mean, the ledge is an immovable object, I guess, at this point. And you
an
know what is a
immovable object?
Object.
It is. We've been up to.
Between an unstoppable force.
I mean.
We fit's deep breath.
What's better, we fit up to or snake up to? We already know
actually,
the answer. Don't answer it. Don't answer it. You don't
need
to answer it.
I'll let
stop. No.
Yo, press
stop.
One. Oh, press
Jesus
one if it's better.
Christ.
Press one. And John, like we said, I didn't know at first if John was comfortable in this matchup, but then I remember they played Looney all the time, and that's
and
very
also
important.
Have Bobo. Don't forget, Bobo's right there, right next to Milkshi. I mean, both
Cheryl.
Very amazing people.
Shout out to Cheryl. Amazing
yes,
artist.
Her.
Shout out to Bobo. Amazing watch game.
Look,
super drippy.
It's the Rob.
Oh, wow. All right.
Better
so another matchup that John plays every week, being House of 3000's very own, gets to play Dill a lot of the time. Dill, she's a phenomenal Rob player over here. You'll actually see her on stream next now that I mention it. So, but in terms of counterpicking, I mean, this probably is going to be not as much as like a matchup to matchup thing as it is just like, you know, Charles being comfortable with Rob. But I don't know how much Charles does play Rob. Maybe they co-main, maybe it's a secondary, but I guess we're about to find out. And John, you know, to the ledge, get the gyro, and throw the soccer ball. Always throw the soccer ball. Or what is it, like a medicine ball?
Mm-hmm. And well, actually, I think it's volleyball, if I'm going to be completely honest.
Yeah.
But I might be also wrong at that, too. Anyways, getting to this game, this is a little bit more even than where we were seeing because, you know, John was playing Snake against Charles before, or the other way around. Either way, we're in a different game. And it's just really good, you know, kind of awareness from John by actually kind of, you know, placing, you know, where they actually use their defensive options really well.
Dude, John is so comfortable just standing there and reacting. It's really, like, humbling to see, honestly. Here we go.
Mean,
yep, he just stands there. do not commit. Just
what
take the deep breath, man.
You just got to breathe. You need some tree and fresh air? That's a Willow reference. I'm so
yeah,
sorry.
Yeah, and I don't know if you caught that, but Wii Fit Header just did 33 on hit, and Up Smash is going to tank it.
Yep.
Here we go. Rob with Gyro in hand, very scary, but there it goes. As we know, Rob with Gyro in hand can lead to some crazy combos, but Rob offstage also is kind of crazy in a weird way. He does a lot, this character.
I mean, Rob could do it all. You need a kill, call Rob.
Yeah.
You need somehow.
A grapple, you know, you get Rob.
You need a reflector too.
I mean, I don't think I really need one, but I'll take one.
I mean, what you need, Rob got
it. I think the way Zan described it, shout out to Zan, is he goes, Rob is a grappler, zoner, and a rushdown. Yeah, a grappler, zoner, rushdown all in one, and he's heavy. And he's got amazing recovery.
The question is
what does he not have, you know what I mean? He's quote unquote comboable. I don't really know what that means. I'm not a top player. The top players say that word, but.
Doesn't have a heart, but I mean, who needs a heart when you're a robot? Who can do it all? Honestly,
who needs emotion? Who needs any of that when you're playing a Rob? Do you even have that if you're a Rob player?
I mean,
honestly,
at this point, you don't need no heart, you don't need no emotions
Charles does not need emotion because Charles will just, you know, take the dub calmly. John, on the other hand, you know, wears their heart under sleeve a little bit more. Hasn't shown much tilt yet. We haven't really seen like anything too tilting.
Ooh.
Okay.
Oh,
is it gonna come down?
No, nope.
It didn't come down.
I think they were trying to read going high up.
Yeah, that's definitely what it was. Very smart.
For sure. We're gonna see John try to get this edge guard, not. But Charles is at 206%.
Yeah.
This is the first time that we've actually seen John actually not really. I think more like more so have a struggle to kill.
Uh-oh.
Gonna get his roll caught. But John's still in this. We need to see John take the stock before we actually.
John is also off stage. Capitalizes off it. Doesn't even matter.
That's crazy.
It is. It was pretty crazy. I love the awareness, actually. All right.
Mm-hmm.
And I mean, if Grunt Charles can't, like, you know, put something together soon, this is just going to be John's game to win, really.
I mean, did you notice how safe that freaking Nair was? That Nair
literally
just, like.
Oh, hello? Dribbling on him? Hello? Is this Jewel?
You gotta be kidding me. Absolutely.
Take notes, Jewel. Dribbling. Uh-oh.
Oh.
That was just such a John numbers down air. Uh-oh.
I mean, John is at two stocks right now.
Not
going to punish.
Just completely whiffing his punish, yeah.
For sure.
But at this point, I mean, it's kind of like, it's not necessarily slipping from Charles as it is just being forcefully, you know, taken from him.
I also want to point out that we've definitely seen that before from John, where John would just throw it up.
Oh, my
Very
goodness.
Nice wave bounce to back air, too.
Wow.
But that was really nice from John.
That
John
was
would
clean.
Actually. Let me tell you what kind of just happened those
Yo,
like,
can we
three
see that
times,
again,
like,
actually? Here, tell me what happened now that we have a beautiful replay. Thank you, Devin.
So they got the gyro, threw the gyro up because they kind of expected, you know, they wanted Charles to do a nair.
Exactly.
They got the nair.
So look.
Did the wave bounce, and then they canceled it.
And just positions perfectly to find the, I think that was deep breathing. I could be incorrect, but deep breathing back air.
Deep
which,
breathing? Does that look like deep
fun
breathing
Fun fact,
to
which
you?
You're never going to remember, is, I'm only going to say it once. Wii Fit deep breath back air is stronger than Charizard sweet spot back air.
Are you sure?
No, I'm sure.
Do you like,
I'm
like that?
Even,
you
I'm
like
not
that
even
handshake?
Making that up.
It's the.